Patrick Swayze's movies is such a beloved classic cult. What can people expect from this new take on the story?
I think, first of all, a whole new form of fighting, you know, in movies. Doug Liman and Garrett Warren and Steve Brown, all of our stunt people, they designed a new form of impact and punching that you've never seen in a movie before. So these fights are all so intense and just full of a type of action you've never seen in fighting. And then I also think a great sense of humor. You know, the original is a classic for so many reasons. Some of it is that, like, you know, it didn't always know when it was being funny, but also the fights were incredible, but we've evolved, you know? So there's a wink to that world. There's a wink to the characters. We never really, I think Dalton never really takes himself too seriously, which I really love. But you can't beat the original, you know? Like, the original is, Patrick Swayze was one of the best, most charismatic actors around. I mean, he raised me with his films. You know, I grew up with Roadhouse, I grew up with Point Break, I grew up with Dirty Dancing and Ghost, and you know, these are formidable films and ones that had such an influence on my upbringing. So for me, you can never really beat the original, but that was never our intention. It was to do something different.
You're not a stranger to fight scenes. You've trained UFC and boxing, but how intimidating was facing Conor
Oh, it was intimidating.
McGregor?
And probably more, you know, even before when we were all, everyone was, Joel Silver, our producer, was chasing to cast Conor for a very long time. And when he finally did, I was so excited. I remember getting the call, and then I was terrified. I was like, oh, wait. But what ended up happening was, you know, he called me and he said, I'm a white belt in making movies and in acting, and I'm here to learn from you. And I think that sense of humility gave me comfort. And I said the same in exchange. I said, you know, I'm a white belt in fighting and I'm here to learn from you. And that's how we walked through this process, was learning back and forth from each other's, you know, experience of the many years we both had in our respective fields.
What do you remember? What do you treasure the most about that moment, about the opportunity of shooting during the UFC 285, I
Yeah,
think?
285. Yeah,
How
yeah.
was the experience? Yes.
It's hard to explain the energy that it feels when you walk into the octagon. I mean, I recognize the octagon as a sacred space. You know, people risk their lives in there. They bring their livelihood in there. It takes years and skill, and something I will never understand to be able to go in there. But the wonder of my job is that I found myself in places that most people never get to go, and it's a great honor. To be in the octagon, performing and playing a UFC fighter in front of a real crowd. I mean, first of all, we were supposed to do it 2 months before at 280, UFC 283, but I got COVID the night before and we had to cancel. So it was so much pressure getting to 285. And then when we got there and we finally pulled it off, everyone was high for like a week after. We kept texting like, oh my God, I can't believe we did it. This is so crazy. So it was very special, very special.
Talking about that, during that event, I saw some videos about that. About this, you watch it, you witnessed it. Our Mexican UFC fighter Alexa Grasso winning the belt, taking the belt from Valentina Shevchenko. I was wondering, this is a mandatory question since I am Mexican. What's your opinion of on our Mexican UFC champion?
Oh, I mean, look, on her, I also on so many Mexican fighters, not only in the UFC but also in boxing, they are fighters that I watch in awe. I think culturally, Mexican fighters are they're incredible. Like the spirit, the heart, the community in particular. I love the support, particularly that a lot, so many of the Mexican fighters give each other, and I just. Look, it's no secret that I adore Mexico, but to watch the fighting and the discipline, but also I think the sportsmanship is something I deeply admire. So yeah, that fight was a great fight, and she is an incredible fighter.